Welcome, hockey fans, to the Joe Louis Arena, the heart of Hockey Town, here on March the 25th, 2007. Happy Sunday. We're here for play-by-play's coverage of the Little Caesars Squirt A. Eiserman Championship. Our combatants, the Farmington Hills Fire, go up against Cranks Hockey Club from Cranks Catering. My name is Rance Ford. I'll be calling all the action for you. Let's get you introduced to these squads first. The visiting team is the Farmington Hills Fire, and they'll send Spencer the Stopper Applebaum into the cage. He wears number one on that Fire uniform. Tyler Sense is playing back on defense, wearing the double zero. Nick Polka is another member of the defensive corps, wearing number three for Farmington Hills. And number four, working at center, is Eric Marson. Wearing a nickel on his hockey sweater is Bryce Becker, and look for him back on the blue line. Defenseman for your Fire, right winger Austin Alger is wearing number 8 for the Farmington squad, and number 10, hardworking centerman Danny McGrail. Jacob Pierce is over on the right wing side. He's wearing the double uno, number 11 for the Farmington Hills squad. Tough Squirt A team here, getting all the way to this championship in the heart of Hockey Town. Let's get you introduced to the rest of the Farmington Hills Fire. Daring to wear the number 13, skating on the right wing side, is Austin Buttrell. And the gritty Colin Juszczyk lines up on the left wing. He wears number 14 for your Fire. Number 15 over on the right wing side, we've got Drew Anastas. And big Dylan Jones is on the left wing, wearing my favorite hockey number, the number 19 for the Fire. 21, that's left winger Kyle McCullough. And Luke Rosicki works on defense, and he wears 77 for the Farmington Hills Fire. How about if our man in the truck will hit the video magical mix master? We'll get you introduced to this brain trust for this excellent Squirt A squad as we roll it over for you. Your head coach is Joe Jones, helped out by Larry Becker, Kevin Alger, and Mike McCullough, along with Tom Anastas. He's a veteran of play-by-play coverage. And then we need another screen because we've got co-managers to bring in for this Farmington Hills Fire team. And I think our man in the truck, Jack Snyder's playing his PlayStation 2 or his Game Boy or something like that. Got to pay attention there. Somebody finally kicked him. Susan Buttrell and Terry Grasicki sharing the managing duties for this 2006-2007 season. Now to get you introduced to the Cranks Hockey Club, here he is, the legend of large, the myth of mass, the fable of fat, the hippo of hockey, ex-Canadian goaltender, your color commentator, Bronco Bobby Wawa.
All right, let's crank it up right now and go wear number 60. It's Brendan Boncori. At left wing, wearing number 9, a good hockey number, it's Austin Levering. On defense, wearing number 10, it's Connor Inger. And Nick at center, wearing number 11, that's Nick Blankenberg. At right wing, wearing number 12, it's Tommy Theo Harris. And they've got the great Connor Jean at left wing, wearing number 13. Mighty Max Jones at center, wear number 19, and Garrett Hall at left wing, wear number 21. Hall at left wing, the Crank is ready to go here this afternoon. It's Crank's Hockey Club here this afternoon for all you fans, and here comes more Cranks at right wing, wear number 22. It's Chris Andrus. On defense, wear number 24, it's Marino Berlini. On defense, wearing number 33, it's William Vanderveen. On defense, wearing number 44, it's Robbie Flannery. Oh, and wearing number 88 on defense, it's Ryan Werner. And look who's on defense, wearing number 91 today, folks. It's Jack Venuto. At right wing, wearing the freight train, number 99. It's Ron Boozer. What a star here this afternoon. Injured today, number 14, Joey Vassalo. What a squad here this afternoon, folks. And here's why they're here today. Look who your head coach is. It's Mighty Matt Werner, assisted by Brad Jones, Andrew Boncori, mighty Rob Flannery, and your manager, great Rick Merlini. What a squad here this afternoon. We're ready to see Cranks Hockey Club against Farmington Hills Fire in a matchup of the century here this afternoon. The fans have been piling in all morning, getting choice seats. And here they come on the ice now.
Well, it's Cranks Hockey Club. First time we've seen a Cranks team down here on the Joe Louis Ice, sponsored by Cranks Catering, and they just took the name, and why not? That's an excellent name for a hockey club, Brian.
Well, it sure is. They crank it up, and it's sponsored by food, and I love Cranks already.
It's in the Squirt A Iserman division. We're getting some pictures. Late arrival there. As we said, one of their players out today, unfortunately. Joey Vassalo broke his wrist just a few days ago.
Cranks rule! There's some of the signs the young ladies have put together, spent the evening on, posing for our camera people. We love that. Now, the young lady doesn't have a sign, but she's got a big smile on her face. There you go. Look at these young ladies, too. Excited about championship hockey here this afternoon.
All have big smiles and anxious to get this game started. And here come your Farmington Hills Fire right down the tunnel there, Bronco.
Yep, fire up. It's Farmington Hills. A lot of great hockey clubs come out of Farmington Hills.
Well, we've seen a lot of good ones over the past years, a few this year as well. And Farmington Hills Fire hoping to bring a trophy back to that arena over on 8 Mile Road there. And you see them trooping out. Here comes the stopper with Fire on the helmet, it looks like, Bronco.
Yep, he's ready this afternoon.
Spencer Applebaum, your stopper for the Farmington Hills Fire. And this promises to be one excellent contest here today as the fans getting it cranked up. A lot of them still at the concession stand. As Bronco was just there, so they have to wait now for them to make more pizzas.
Well, they do, because I kind of bought them out here today, but the fans will have plenty to go around after they cook a few more.
Brendan Boncori getting set. Getting some tune-up shots from the Cranks Hockey Club down at his end.
Well, Brendan has been the only goalie for this team for 2 years, but you know he also plays lacrosse and tennis in the summer.
Those are both athletic sports as well. And you see some of the Cranks faithful, and that's the fan club of Robbie Flannery up there.
Yep, a nice hat on the lady over there.
Yeah,
right.
A nice poster as well. Good to see, and you like to see the fans participating. Spencer Applebaum, there he is, the stopper. Wearing number one because he says he is number one. And he likes Pavel Datsyuk as far as his favorite NHL player. Loves steak. He always tells everyone, great shot. He's known to throw his equipment all over the locker room, and he doesn't wear socks while on the ice. Maybe they should call him shoeless or sockless instead of stopper.
Number three is my brother from the Fire.
The Nick Boca fan club right there. That's probably the president. Made up a poster. Make sure to get it on camera here for this big game. Right in the heart of Hockey Town. There you see him right over the Hockey Town logo as we get the touch of the gloves, Bronco.
Yep, big moment for these youngsters here this afternoon. They honor to play at the Joe Louis Arena for a championship competition. They're going to remember this for the rest of their lives. There's a big poster with all the players listed on it. We can't go that quickly down the line there, but I think they've got them all on there. I don't think they missed anyone.
Pretty sure they got all the Cranks represented on that poster. Look at this, a little synchronized cheering here.
All right.
I think that's maybe some. We borrowed a couple of the Pistons cheerleaders there, Bronco.
That looks like them right there. They look pretty good at it.
As we get set to go with this first period, Spencer Applebaum all set between the pipes. And here comes Brendan Boncori as he'll get squared away in the cage for Cranks. And we're just about ready to get this one started right at the center ice. Hockey Town logo, and we're underway. Cranks takes the faceoff, swept back by Gene. And it'll be sent all the way back down into the Fire end. But it looks like it'll be a quick icing call. And we'll have to troop everybody to the right-hand side of your television screen down deep into the Cranks Hockey Club zone. We'll bring it down to the left side of Boncori as they get squared off. Direct a little traffic there by our official. That's swept back by Marson. There's a shot right on, ripped right on Boncori, and he has to dive on it in the blue ice. Sending the shot from a step inside the blue line after the faceoff there was Tyler Sensky. Sense, as you see him step across the blue line, rips that through a little bit of traffic. But Boncori there at the other end to collect that. And Sense's favorite hockey player is Nick Lindstrom. His favorite food is pears. He warms up during the game. Part of his warm-up includes eating a Hershey bar. I think Bronco used to do that. And he has the hardest shot on the team. Teammates call him the cannon. There's a one coming right on and steered aside again. Drifts off to the far side, controlled here by your fire. Opposing team parents are often heard to call Mr. Sense Big Boy. Pass ahead there by Jones, unable to collect it, was number 13, Gene, was a little bit behind him. Getting in there into the corner comes Jonesy once again, as it's stolen off of his stick as he was fighting against Big Sensky. Sensky, and trying to hold it in, Chris Andrus gets tangled up with the, like Dill Pickles over there. This will be an icing against Farmington Hills Fire. We already saw early in this game, Max Jones, Jonesy working hard for Cranks.
Well, Max is a 98. His mom and dad are U of M graduates, and his dad played in the NHL, notably with Wayne Gretzky with the LA Kings. His older brother plays AAA for Little Caesars.
And Max Jones' dad would be Brad Jones. Scramble out in front of the net. That shot blocked. Is jumping into the play comes number 21, Garrett Hall, and getting the puck covered at the lip of the blue ice is Applebaum. Right on the doorstep there was Blankenberg. Big Garrett Hall sending the tough angle shot. Take another look at it. Replayed down low. See Blankenberg and Hall fighting for this opportunity. Hall had a couple of shots at it. Was blocked out in front by your Farmington Hills Fire. And here's Hall. Flings one just from the end line and a tough angle, but Applebaum had to be sharp on the stop with a couple of Cranks players right there in front. Fighting for that biscuit was Blankenberg, but a nice shot. There's a few shots out there by Big Garrett Hall for the Cranks team.
Well, Garrett has most of his hockey career in roller hockey, but has adjusted nicely to the ice. Garrett also plays travel baseball in the summertime.
He works along the near side again. Farmington Hills Fire trying to pop it loose of the zone. Cranks will move it around to the other corner now. Jumping in there on the play, getting in there. Grisicki, and I hope I have this nickname right, but they have the Fat Force down as a nickname for him. That used to be your nickname for a while, didn't it?
For a while, forever. I'll tell you, roly-poly, load. I've been called them all.
Either that or you were on that team. Play looked offside, but it continues. Trying to sweep it out front on the backhand was Blankenberg. Comes back to the blue line, but that'll get loose. And look out, race for the puck down along the boards. Nice job working in there. Is number 10, sending the shot. Oh, and a big stop for Boncori. Comes back out front again. Nice job to get in there and knock it off the stick by 21 Hall again. Good job, chance in there as McGrail broke through a couple defensemen. This is going to be picked up by Sensky. Here's Sense all alone, shoots and scores!
Oh, he made it, he was alone, and he put it right in the net. What a play!
He went into the corner with it, tucked it inside the pipe as he picked it up at center ice, turned it around. I don't know if he caught the Cranks on a line change or what, but he just walked right down the slot with it and ended up one-on-one with Brendan Boncori. And it looks like he may have caught Cranks as he just from the hash marks and put the perfect shot stick side on Boncori, Bronco.
Yeah, he found that corner of the net. He put it in. He was alone, and I don't know quite what happened here. We're going to see it one more time.
I guess the Hershey bar before the game must have worked. Did you see the steal away? And I think Cranks was changing. They got caught badly here, Bronco.
Looks like that's what they did. He's all alone coming in and puts it right in the back of the net. What a shot by 00.
Boncori stepped up to pick up the pit challenge, but it was a perfect shot. Hard wrister, as they said, that number 00, Sensky, has the hardest shot on the team. Tough for Boncori to catch up with, Bronco.
Yep, he showed good sense on that play.
9:55 to go in the first period of play, and the Farmington Hills Fire jump on top with the 1-0 lead. Fight for it in the Hockey Town logo. Cranks will pick it up, trying to sweep it along the near side penalty boxes there. Moving up on the play comes Billy Bob Becker. Here's Becker all the way through as he battles along the boards. Billy Bob wears the number of his favorite hockey player, Nick Lindstrom. He loves ribs with a Sprite. It's a tasty little meal there. And he also he ties the back of his jersey in a ponytail. And we'll always take a penalty rather than let somebody score on Spencer. So as long as you're taking the good penalties, Bronco.
That's right. There are good penalties and there are some bad ones.
This comes all the way back out to center ice. Lifted on the backhand by Connor Inger as Crank steps across the blue line. Send the shot in softly wide of the cage. Jumping into the corner there. Austin Levering goes down.
Well, Austin Levering is a gritty player and excellent penalty killer. One of the top point scorers on the team.
Well, not checking division, but they're banging off each other pretty good right now. Some good defense between the blue lines. That's swept off the near boards as Cranks crosses into the Farmington Hills zone once again. And excellent defensive work being done right there again by Becker. Bryce Becker is the actual name, but the team calls him Billy Bob. That's swept up the near side by Connor Jean. And Becker chases back for it. Jean's put in a couple of good shifts so far for the Cranks Hockey Club.
Well, Connor Jean, actually, he's a good football player. He plays football in the fall as well.
Bronco used to play some football on a Canadian football team, and they didn't have as many players for the team, so he'd play the whole line.
Yeah, I did. I could really block for that running back.
Look out, swept out front. Nice block. There's a rebound shot swept right on by Blankenberg. Fighting to get it out of there is Boca. Boca tussling with Hoya. Number 11, Blankenberg, not afraid to go in there. They push it out front again. But it's knocked away into the faceoff circle, unable to hold it in. Van Der Veen worked up to the blue line, but not out. Getting the stick out of the backhand as Batrell gets it out to neutral ice. Well, number 13, Austin Batrell, has some different kind of routines out there as he likes to beat Grosicki to the locker room. He likes to be the first one there. I guess they got a running competition here. There's a shot right on as getting that shot on was Connor Jean. There's a rebound shot that may have hit the goalpost. There's pressure being put on by Cranks Hockey Club trying to get the equalizer here. Terrell's favorite hockey player is Sidney Crosby, and he'll always sit down for a pizza and a frozen Coke. He likes wearing Michigan State stuff when he's not in uniform, and before big games, he watches a highlight video of Alexander Ovechkin. As they fight for it at center ice, right between the penalty boxes once again. Digging it loose there was 44 Flannery. Flannery gets his leg on it, sweeps it back into the fire zone, but that play is going to go offside. Looks like they're going to push it all the way down by the indication of the man with the striped shirt. As you get a look at the Cranks bench here, Bronco.
Yep, the young players all getting their turn and opportunity to play championship hockey here today.
A lot of hockey experience on that Cranks Hockey Club bench. We'll see, they get a nice opportunity right here with Connor Jean picking up the loose puck. Skates it into the face-off circle and lets this fly on the stopper. And the stopper just got enough of that with the left arm. Good job by the Spider-Man, Juszczyk, to get in there and sweep it out. But ripped right back on by number 22, Chris Andrus, for your Cranks Hockey Club.
Well, Chris has had a successful year because he's been an excellent playmaker all year.
Here at the Farmington Hills. Down in the Cranks end, trying to collect it there was Anastas, Superman. He's got a couple of comic book heroes out on this fire club. But the Cranks able to work it out of there. Chasing it down goes Becker. Becker fighting to keep it away from big number 21. That's Hall. They both go crashing to the ice. And looking for room to get it out of there is Drew Anastas. He's the Superman on the Farmington Hills Fire, and I guess he practices changing clothes like Superman because the coach says he's the fastest undresser in the locker room. He's out of the locker room within 2 minutes, and sometimes he wears PJs to practice, and he also never wears the same, he doesn't wear matching socks.
what's the difference? As long as they cover your feet, for crying out loud.
I don't know. Superman, I always thought his outfit was kind of a snazzy dresser. He has the same color socks on.
Oh, there's a shot on the short side. Jumping in there was Austin Alger. AA as he goes down, but he jumped between the Cranks Hockey Club defense and pumped that one past Brendan Boncori, who went down to stop the original shot.
And you see the Farmington Hills Fire faithful as they come to life again. Now a 2-0 lead. is that one. You see it right on top of it as number eight, Austin Alger, getting in there to put the goal past Boncori. He really crashed the net on that, Bronco.
Yeah, they moved right in on him. Wild attempt, and they score. And
the cameraman a little in close down low there. We'll have to go back up and take a look at this one. We'll take a look at the far end of the ice. As you see, it's originally Alger who puts it into the Franks Hockey Club end. Goes in behind the cage and will be picked up here. Looks like 24 Merlini who gets there for it. He tries to sweep it back around, but a nice job to step in here by Danny McGrail. Sends the shot on net. Rebound comes loose. And Boncori is down and crashing in there. Alger, AA, stuffs that one into the back of the cage. We'll take one more look at it from top. Up top is pushed into the zone by Alger. Those are Merlini tracks it down in deep for Cranks. Goes to clear it and is jumping on him is Marson. But intercepting is McGrail. He heaves a shot at the net and sliding right in between two defensemen. There you see it. Austin Alger powers it into the cage with Boncori scrambling between the pipes there, Branko.
Yeah, old double A. He didn't have to think much. He just moved right in. Good reaction time, and he puts it in the net.
Well, Austin Alger likes Alexander Ovechkin and Dale Earnhardt. That's where he wears the number 8. 5:38 left to go in this first period of play. 2-0 lead for your Fire. And Mr. Alger likes pizza with a fruit smoothie. And I don't know, maybe that's what that is right there. I don't know if they're selling the fruit smoothies down at the stand. He wants to go to Ohio State when he goes to college. I hope he rethinks that. He is a cool kid with an awesome slap shot. And he's great at stick handling, one of the fastest guys on the team. Working along the boards, Boca trying to hold it out of there. Nice stop at the blue line by Inger, but it's popped back out to center ice. Nice little move here by Theo Harris, but he loses an edge at the top of the circle, and the Fire will take it away.
Tommy Theo Harris is a high-energy kid. He gets the team going. He has a strong wrist shot. His dad's the team webmaster and DJ.
Looks like that... Biscuit popped back over the blue line off sides. And they're going to take it just to the Farmington Hills side of the center ice to face it off. As Cranks wins the faceoff, spinning over for Levering. He had it taken away. It's swept in wide of Boncori. Getting there first is McGrail, number 10. He meets up with a couple of Cranks players. Goes off along the board, swept out on the backhand. Oh, look out here, breaking in behind players. Oh, it was Inger, but the Fire quickly back on the play. Fire will work it out along the far boards. Long pass over, connects nicely there with McGrail, and McGrail looked like he might have been hauled down. The official right there has stayed quiet. Look out,
right
rebound shot. Oh, and a couple of big chances for the Fire. And a great stops for Boncori in there, Bronco.
Oh, Brendan, he did a heck of a job with all that traffic. They're still working on him.
Trying to stuff it around on a backhand. Number 10 once again. Danny McGrail with a couple of good chances on this shift. McGrail's favorite hockey player in the NHL is Manny Legacy as he sweeps out front. There's a quick shot. Oh, bouncing around. We had a pile of players.
Front.
Still loose there, trying to dive on it is Boncori. And it's going to be taken out of there by Cranks. Dangerous opportunity right there for the Farmington Hills Fire. Cranks now bringing it down. But the two defenders right there for the Fire. There's a tough angle shot. They try and stuff it through. It works back out along to the near boards. Good job to hold it in. That's swept through the high slot off to the far corner. As Cranks looking to put on some pressure. Shot is blocked in the faceoff circle. Going to be dug out by Senske. And as we were saying about our man McGrail, some of the coach's comments on him is that he puts more tapes on his shins than his stick. Always wins the faceoff. Was heard to tell Drew, number 15, I know you're jealous of me, but control yourself. I don't know why Drew Anastas would be jealous, Bronco. He's got the nickname Superman. You can't get any better than that.
Oh, no, that is an excellent name for a hockey player.
As Cranks works it down again, pass back up to the blue line. Can't quite hold it in. Good job to stay with that play, however. Number 33, William Vanderveen, didn't give up, even though he went down on the ice.
Well, William's hockey career began in Royal Oak with many others on the team, like Robbie Flannery, Jack Van Dot, Tommy Levering, Joey Vasello, and Chris Andrus.
Well, that's one of the reasons why this core of this Cranks hockey team is so good, Branko.
Yep, they played together for a while, and it makes a big difference. Just ask your coaching staffs about that.
There's a long shot taken by Marson, dribbles wide of the stick of Bon Corey. Goes off into the corner, getting in to deliver the check as Marson, as he gets right back into the play for the Fire. Pops loose into the faceoff circle. Nice little move there by Gene. Gets it out through center ice, trying to catch up with that as Jonesy. The Fire is a good job right on that blue line by Nick Boca, taking the hits there and being thrown that playoff side. Take another look at this chance here for the Farmington Hills Fire. As you see, breaking in was McGrail, went down on the ice, and he manages to sweep it out front. Knocking down the pass was Bon Corey, but the rebound was right there for number 13, Austin Buttrell. Yes, good scoring chance for the Farmington Hills Fire. And it'll be saved back at the blue line as it's worked back in deep. Looking for another chance here is going to be Danny McGrail, as he comes around from behind the cage, tries to stuff it in on a wraparound backhand there, but just getting there in the nick of time was Brendan Bon Corey. You see good pressure out there by Farmington Hills Fire trying to add to their lead. And another chance to look at from up top here is there's enough nice pass out front, ripped right on target there. And it's a scramble for the Biscuit. And sending the backhand shot through was Juszczyk, the Spider-Man right there. And you see just a pile of players right at the lip of that blue ice before it's finally dug out by Cranks. Look at a Cranks opportunity is coming in from center ice is Max Jones. Jonesy through the face-off circle and gets tied up with a couple of Fire players as he tries to work in, but picking up the loose puck is Levering. Sends a tough angle shot right on. Rebound was loose there. Good job by the Farmington Hills Fire to sweep it out of harm's way. Both of these teams have been putting on some good pressure out there, Branko.
They sure have here today, and we see more of the fans here with big smiles on their faces here watching the contest this afternoon.
Enjoying the Squirt A. Iserman Championship. This is swept out of the faceoff circle all the way back down to the Cranks blue line. Up along the near side, carrying across comes Buttrell. His shot hits a player. Look out, rebound! Oh, and it trickles right to the goal mouth.
Oh, man, right in the blue ice, it stalled out.
Juszczyk was tied up a little bit, but managed to get the shot off, and it trickled behind Bon Corey right through the blue ice.
Oh, it's
coming
still
right
around.
Back on, and he'll get that covered up.
Some dangerous play you just saw, folks. Puck sitting around that blue ice, have to get it out of there.
Loser fighting to protect things in front of his goaltender, Bon Corey. And we take another look as carrying up the near side is Buttrell. He lines up the shot. You see the defenseman hopping up in front to take that block. Coming late here is number 14. That's a Juszczyk. And a big stop there for Bon Corey. Bon Corey's had to stand on his head here lately, Branko.
Yeah, they putting a lot of heat on the young man.
You see sending the tough, trying to sweep it out front was 13 Buttrell. And a chance in there as it looked like McGrail got in behind the defense again. Had number 14 right with him as well, Juszczyk. Spider-Man wearing the number 14 because it was one of the numbers left, and he likes Brendan Shanahan. And his favorite player is Joe Sakic, and he's happy to have a Mountain Dew in his hand when he wants to be refreshed. His best friends with number 10, that would be Danny McGrail. And his coach says he plays with a lot of intensity. He explodes off the bench, and he shows up at practice wearing a lot of ties. I don't know if he ties those himself or if those are the clip-ons like Branko wears.
Yes, I have to have a clip-on, and they're so short, they come up about 3 inches below my neck.
Puck drifting in there on Bakori again, and he decides to get it covered up.
Nice big poster here for your Farmington Hills Fire. 00!
Tyler Senske fan club right there, making a poster up to support both their team and favorite player here today. There's Senske out there right now as he works to hold it inside. Sends it along the boards. It'll drift into the far corner. And is trying to establish position out front was Alger once again, as it'll be the Cranks Hockey Club trying to work it out. And swept out on the backhand by number 19, Jones. Here come your Cranks team. Nice job to poke it off the stick at the last second. As Connor Jean was lining up the shot, sweeping it into the slot was Blankenberg. It'll bounce off to the far wall. First one on it is Becker. Becker sends it down. This should be an icing call. As we're down to fumes here in our first period of play, and although the Cranks has had some good pressure, the stopper has been true to his nickname so far, Bronco.
Yep, Spencer Applebaum has been unstoppable today.
Unbeatable so far, as Cranks still working on getting their first goal on the board. As it's a 2-0 lead for the Farmington Hills Fire. Here they come again. Look out, shot by McGrail. That's blocked out in front. Getting it in the corner, dig it loose as Venuti gets it over to his teammates, swept around the far boards.
Well, Jack has played since he was 4 for Coach Flannery. Very solid defenseman.
So it works out, and carrying down will be Garrett Hall. Here's Garrett Hall lining up the shot, sends it up high. Oh, look out. Applebaum didn't know where it had gone for a second. He may have got a piece of it with the blocker as the shot was sent up high. Trying to sweep it around on the wraparound there was Blankenberg. And, oh, a little extracurricular after the horn goes to end this first period of play, Bronco.
Yep, pretty exciting first period of play. A lot of action around the net.
See Blankenberg working out there with a lot of energy. And they'll talk about it at the end of the period here. In good shape, Joe Jones, Farmington Hills Fire Squad, Bronco.
Yep, talking to his players right now. Love to have a microphone on the coaches. We have to do that maybe next season.
And Matt Werner and company going to try and crank the Cranks Hockey Club up as they're diagramming some plays, as they need to find a way to get something past Spencer Applebaum for the Farmington Hills Fire. Let's take a look at a little bit of action before we bring in these stats. Is carrying it down, number 21. Garrett Hall's had a couple of scoring chances, and this one lifts the high shot. Going up to get it was Stopper. I'm not sure if he got a piece of that on the way through. Looked like it was going to be a little too high on the shot anyway there, Bronco.
Yep, that's what it looks like. 12 minutes on the clock for period number two.
2-0 lead in the Squirt A Iserman Championship for the Farmington Hills Fire over Cranks Hockey Club.
Well, now it's time for game stats after one period of play. Shots on goal, the Fire with 12, the Cranks with 7. Faceoffs won, 6 for the Fire, 3 for the Cranks. Quality scoring chances, 5 for the Fire, 2 for the Cranks, and we did not even have one single penalty in the first period of play. That's coaching, that's discipline, that's championship hockey at its best here.
It was a pretty rough Squirt A period, but the whistle stayed quiet, and nobody had to visit the sin bin. And now it's time, hockey fans, to put on your thinking caps as we're going to visit the Name the Hall of Famer game. There's your visual clue. That's all we're going to give you. We'll let you know that it's a very famous hockey photo, one of the most famous hockey photos. We have not doctored it in any way. It was taken at the very end of a Stanley Cup series where the man in question scored the winning goal. If you used his last name, you should be able to make just about any kind of medal. That's all we're going to give you for now, but the second part is you got to hunt us down here at the Joe Louis Arena. We're not allowed the regular play-by-play booth. Not since Bronco and the infamous sauerkraut incident. But if you can find us, boy, Bronco's got a great prize on tap for you today.
Yes, sir, this is a prize of a lifetime, an expenses paid trip to my new summer camp, Wishy Washy Wawa. I'll tell you, thin is not in, fat's where it's at. And for recreation, the famous Speedo Tug of War will be held. You get to tug on my Speedos. The first night, it'll be Cabin A, the tons of funds, versus Cabin B, the wide loads. The championship round, the happy hippos that I coach in Cabin C. You got to be 400 pounds even getting that cabin, baby.
Well, there's a different kind of championship banners up here in the rafters at the Joe Louis Arena. I don't know if any of the players on those teams were 400 pounds. But, well, it's a possible bet anyway. We get set to go with the second period of play as the stopper has been perfect so far. Gets set to go between the pipes. Brendan Boncori ready for your Cranks Hockey Club. And we're ready and we're underway here. Second period of play. Yes, looking for a couple of goals. Cranks coming across with it. Blankenberg sends a pass. Oh, just tipped off the stick of the number 99, Boozer. Couldn't quite get that pass from Blankenberg.
Well, Ron Boozer's had a great year. His dad has played with notable locals like Mike Madonna and Doug Waite.
Well, Mike Madonna, of course, Westland, where play-by-play is from, and they've renamed the arena, the Madonna Arena, to honor him. As that's pushed back out to center ice, number 11. He's been working so hard out there, Nick Blankenberg. Boy, does he play with a lot of energy.
Well, Nick Blankenberg was acquired 2 years ago on waivers from the Troy Sting. This move has paid off for the Cranks team, as Nick has been a solid contributor at both ends of the ice. It will surely haunt the Sting for some time, as Nick scored two goals in the 4-3 win when Cranks knocked Troy out of the Little Caesars playoffs en route to this championship game.
Well, Blankenberg comes from a hockey family, too. It's a hockey family affair. His older brother playing AAA hockey, and his dad's involved with the hockey equipment industry. Look out, as the Fire getting some pressure on. Shot deflected wide off the stick of Boca out there. As they battle for it in behind the Cranks cage, comes to the near corner. Jumping in there to get it goes Dill Pickles, Dylan Jones. Swept back out front, the high slot, throwing the shot toward the net. Once again, Boca, we get a whistle to stop the action. Looks like we're going to have somebody sent to the sin bin here, Branko, our first customer.
Our first penalty of the afternoon comes here in the second period of play.
Looks like 24, Marino Marlini, who's getting escorted to the box. We'll give Farmington Hills Fire a chance to add to their lead on the power play. The indication was an elbowing call. Let's see if we can pick it up here. Down low on the replays, you see that shot coming through from the stick of Boca. And Farmington Hills Fire had the good scoring chance in here. I'm not sure if we got the penalty here. There's Marlini right there as he bumps in to, I think that's it right there, as he just threw the Fire player off the puck there, Branko.
Yep,
and the
obvious call.
And so Marino Marlini, who's got the name that just rolls off the tongue, M&M there, is in the sin bin. First chance to play our PlayStation 2 by either team, Branko.
That's right. We've got great games on there. Pizza Pong, Cake Mania is on there.
And while Marlini sits in the penalty box, we'll get in the press box information on him.
Well, the thing is, with Marino's brother has played 3 seasons in the Ontario Hockey League, and most recently for the Plymouth Whalers. His dad, Rick, the team manager, was featured as the home builder for Extreme Home Makeover on ABC, Famous Family.
Well, both teams getting some television time, because I know they cover the Whalers on some cable. There's a shot on, kicked aside by Boncori. As Farmington Hills Fire go right to work on this power play. Good job to jump in front of that shot and block it by Venuti. As the Fire coming at it from all angles, hold it in at the blue line. Send it back along the boards. This will get in deep. Once again, in behind the cage, but nice job to jump back on defense by Venuti once again. Here's a long shot. Take a deflect right on. Long shot taken by Senski. Skipped off of Inger right in on Boncori. As Inger will get it, and looking for an opening, but it's held in.
Well, Connor Inger just got his braces off and just celebrated his 10th birthday. Happy birthday, Connor!
Tangle up along the near side. Looked like Juszczyk got the stick out there too far, so it looks like we'll have some 4-on-4 skating. As you see, the Cranks trying to collect it and work it out, and the stick in between the legs there. Juszczyk, the Spider-Man, so he makes a trip to the sin bin. So after no penalties in the first period, we got a couple early calls here in the second. Going to be a tripping call against Colin. Mr. Juszczyk has to go to the Huskow, and we'll take a look at some of this Farmington Hills Fire pressure on the power play. Here you see that shot came up high. May have been played with the high stick, but nothing called there. And as it's pushed back around the cage, it's number 10, Inger jumping into the defensive action there. Can't stop the pass out front. And Farmville's Fire able to get the shot off right there, right on target on Boncori, Branko.
Yeah, you saw it coming with some of those bodies out front. Heads up play.
Grail being a real playmaker out there for the Farmville's Fire. Got that pass to use check for the good chance. And then we got one other here for the Farmington Hills Fire as they working on the power play here. I believe it's McGrail to go back after it again behind the net. He's trying to slow him down as number 91 Venuto. As this pass comes out from in behind the cage, taking the long shot here is Tyler Sensky, and you see that nice left toe save there for Boncori, Branko.
Boy, that was just a beautiful save. You got to see it right in your living room. Great reaction.
9:42 left in the second period of play. They haven't posted the penalty yet, but we've got some four-on-four skating, and if things should remain the same, Cranks will get the short power play opportunity as the faceoff comes back out to the side of the zone. Anastas in there at center for the Farmington Hills Fire. And trying to track it down along the near boards. They scramble in there for it. This is the Fat Force got in there. Work it in. Here comes Cranks. And the pass out front doesn't quite connect. Pokey McCullough will track it down along the far board. Sends the pass all the way across. Kyle McCullough wears number 21 because it was his dad's number. And he likes cake and ice cream with his Mountain Dew. He wants to go to U of M. Loves telling jokes with his teammates to get himself warming up in the pregame, bringing the puck all the way down. There's 77 Grisicki as it's steered out of harm's way. And McCullough got a mohawk so he could win a bag of Cheetos in a crazy hair contest. And he's always the last one out of the locker room. Boy, he sounds like your son, Branko.
I'll tell you what, yeah, you got to get in those eating contests. Those are great.
Well, it's a crazy hair contest, getting a mohawk for a bag of Cheetos. Branko would do that for just one Cheeto chip.
Well, I don't have any hair, so that way I wouldn't be able to do much with the hairstyle. I only got about six or seven of them I could curl.
You could paint one on.
I could. Get that spray paint they used to put on your head, make it look like you had hair.
Working forward in behind the cage is coming out of there with it was Blankenberg as Pierce was right in there for the Farmington Hills Fire. Cranks works it all the way down now on the working on the power play. 22 along the near boards. That's Andrus, but stolen away. And it'll be swept back out through neutral ice by your Farmington Hills Fire. Cranks gives it right back. At the Fire are there. Spoka sends it all the way down the ice. Well, Boca is one that doesn't mess around in the locker room. He loves U of M hockey. He wants to go either U of M, MSU, or Notre Dame. And to get set for a hockey game, he likes listening to his iPod. Favorite player is Sidney Crosby, and he's another Mountain Dew fan, but he likes to eat donuts with his Mountain Dew. Just look out. Here comes Cranks again, and man in the fort back there. Tyler Setsky thrown to the side of the net, but that's blocked off. As Jonesy tried to sweep it out front. And we might have another infraction here, Branko.
It looks like the ref's skating over to the table for giving an explanation here of what's going on. And here comes...
it's going to be another Farmington Hills Fire player. This time getting caught looks like Billy Bob Becker that's got to sit on the pine for a couple of minutes or less. We'll see if we can pick it up here as he's going to get caught for interference. On the play, and there you see it right there as it looked like he took out Garrett Hall from behind. Tyler Sensky, in the meanwhile, do excellent defensive work on Jonesy. Jonesy sent it to the side of the net, but right there was Alger to steer it out of harm's way. 7:36 left in the second period of play. And I think we have a slow typer operating the scoreboard here today. Bryce Becker in the penalty box for the Farmington Hills Fire for 2 minutes or less. That'll be swept around to the near side. As the Farmington Hills Fire just killed one penalty, but now they're going to have to kill a full play power play opportunity for Cranks.
Oh,
look out
to the boards.
Cranks player got tangled up. They score!
Oh, man, right after the
Farmington
crash.
Hills Fire scores after Cranks got a couple of players tangled up behind the net. And Danny McGrail makes him pay, Bronco.
Well, he sure did. We're going to watch a collision there because they really sail into these forts. Look at this. Oh, man.
McGrail slowed down. The two players got tangled up. McGrail picked it up off the boards, went out front, spun around on a backhand shot. And Boncori arguing this one. I think he said he was in the crease, but you see the Cranks player is still struggling to get up and limping a little bit. As he gets up is Jonesy. As we'll take another look at this from up top as it's swept down right in between the two defenders is Danny McGrail. And the Cranks defense gets there first, but it's a collision and a tangle up. And hopefully number 19, Jones, is going to be all right. But what a beautiful play there. Staying on it there was Danny McGrail as he took it out front, spun back around on the backhand. Boncori was at the other side of the net, and he's arguing about something there with the official, Branko.
That's what it looks like right now. But, boy, Danny, with a heads-up play, saw that puck, pulled it away, and made a spin-around move and put it in the net.
Well, that's going to be a shorthanded goal for number 10, Danny McGrail. Now 3-0 in favor of the Farmington Hills Fire. And the Cranks Hockey Club has got to see if they can get it rolling on this power play, Branko.
Yep, we got to Cranks it up.
It'll be pushed in deep by Blankenberg. Farmington Hill Fire get there. Blankenberg in the corner with it. Looking out front, he'll send it around to the far side. Chasing down after it is Garrett Hall in between a couple of Farmington Hill Fire players. Nastas in there. Number 10 jumping in there along the boards. McGrail once again as they come away with it. Oh, and swept over to the near side. Boozer. Rebound Ronnie. He'll push it back to the point. It'll be pushed back in to Ronnie sweeps it in behind the cage. And battling out there for a chance is Boozer, Bronco.
Yep, he's really working hard out there right now to try to turn things around here.
He's pushed into the slot, turning around with the shot.
Oh.
There is Garrett Hall. Ends up to the side of the cage, sent around to the near boards, and the Fire will get it loose back to center ice. Sent all the way back down into the Cranks end. Going back after it is Inger. Inger steers it away from number 13, Batrell. It'll be held in by the Fire. Fire looking for another shorthanded chance. Working in there was Juszczyk. Look out, there's a shot right on. His number 13 was right there. Batrell set the shot on the loose puck, but nice save for Boncori. As Cranks will look to work it down once again. Cutting to the left, right wing side. I'm sorry, don't know my left from my right. Drifts off the stick on Theo Harris. And the Fire work it up the boards, but there's Theo Harris along the boards to hold it in, trying to work past the big fat force. Grzycki stays right on him in the corner. As the fat force takes his number from number 77, Paul Coffey, who used to play for the Red Wings at one point in his career. And he likes pizza, hot dogs, Slurpees, and a Dr. Pepper to go with him. He wants to go to MSU or Ohio State. Come on, that's no choice. And he likes getting to the rink first before Austin Batrell or Tyler. Always passes the puck to an open teammate rather than take the goal for himself. And has a great laugh.
We have a penalty being called here. Rance, number 19, going to the sin bin.
Well, it's going to be Max Jones who's got to go into the bin. As see if we can pick it up here. Play going off into the corner. He's going to get tangled over up over there with Becker. They're going to call him for tripping on the play. Not sure if that was it right there. And you see the Cranks Hockey Club trying to get a goal on the board right here. And there you see the backhand shot taken. I'm not sure. Well, the tripping call, I think, was off along the wall there, Branko.
That's what it looks like, yep.
And we'll take a look as the Farmington Hills Fire had a shorthanded opportunity out here. Jumping into the action comes Juszczyk, the Spider-Man. Stays with that puck and knocked off of his stick, but right over is to his teammate, ripping that shot right in on Boncori, Branko.
Yep, he really had some mustard on it.
It was a good chance over there for Austin Petrell. But Boncori, they've gotten a couple of goals by him, Branko, but Boncori has made some excellent stops out there.
Well, so far he's perfect on the afternoon.
Well, just after the Fire kill the power play opportunity, they'll go on the power play with the man advantage. Chance to add to this 3-0 lead here at the Joe Louis Arena. He's working at center right now is number 15. That's Drew Anastas, Superman, that's pushed into the fire end. Getting on it is Billy Bob. Billy Bob trying to work it out along the boards. He'll get some help from McCullough. Good job to track that down and hold it in by number 9, Levering. Can't get past the hard-working double-aught spy, Senske. Yes, now it's a Farmington Hills Fire to skate it in. Make a pass into the slot. Oh, backhanded. Unable to get much on it was Anastas into the corner after it goes Pierce. In behind the cage, getting a stick on. Oh, beautiful pass out front. Knocked off the stick of Anastas before he could pull the trigger. And off along the near boards, coming down with it comes Theo Harris. Theo Harris will get it back, sends the shot on goal. Applebaum is there and decides to cover it up with a Crank Hockey Club member coming right down the slot on him. Some good chances at both ends out there, Bronco.
Yep, we're seeing some exciting play right now as they've turned it up a notch.
You see handling the puck is Flannery, but it's going to be number 21 carrying across the blue line comes Pokey. And Pokey sends a pass across a little behind his teammate, but getting a little tip on it there was Anastas. And it just drifted wide of Boncorry, but jumping on it in the corner goes Jacob Pierce. And we'll take a look up top here. Chance coming down for number 12, Tommy Theo Harris. Feeds it right through the legs of the Farmington Hills Fire defense. Picks it up on the other end. He sweeps it in on Applebaum, but the stopper put the big goalie paddle down horizontal on the ice and grabbed it before it could get away from him, Bronco.
Yep, nice play by Spencer.
Like he had Levering coming in there looking for the rebound chance. The faceoff will stay to the left side of the stopper. Is through the slot. It'll get kicked back out through center ice. Tracking it down over there is 24 Merlini. Looked out, kicked ahead here by Marson. Faceoff circle, that's blocked off. And it works right into your living room here. Vanderveen digs it loose, sends it to the corner, and tagging his man Eric Marson, getting tangled up with Connor Jean. And Eric Marson, he takes his number from Vincent LeCavalier of Tampa Bay. Favorite food is mac and cheese. Plans to go to either North Carolina or Michigan State. And his coach says he likes to sing in the locker room in a weird voice. His skates lace up backwards, and he only has a few coaches know how to help lace them.
Yeah, I've never heard of that one before.
I don't know either. It sounds highly technical to me. Here's Marson picking it up. Got the stick on the Crank hockey player there, and I think we got a penalty. Well, they may not be calling the penalty. He was trying to get untangled and looked like he took a hack there, Bronco, but yep, nothing called.
We're not going to say anything to the referee.
Eric Marson, he'll come off for a change here, and nothing whistled on the play. McGrail battling against Inger, and it's McGrail works it in deep. In behind the cage it goes, and McGrail all tied up here. As it's lifted the circle, but not out. There's a shot right on. They score!
And they put it in the net this time.
Austin Batrell found it right in the faceoff circle and sent the shot back on Becori. He'll pick up the goal here, Bronco. Unofficially, an unassisted goal for number 13. That's Austin Batrell. As you see, sweeping it out of there is Inger, but Batrell finds it right about at the faceoff dot and just sneaks it through the left skate of Boncorry. Boncorry was leaning to the right, got that left skate back there, Bronco. He's upset, thought he had it. But he knocked down quite a bit of it, but it just did squeak over the goal line.
Yeah, you could see it just dribble across the line at slow speed.
Brendan Becori upset with that one. As you see it working behind the cage, all tied up back there was McGrail. McGrail stayed with it. And then as they tried to work it out, put it right on the stick here for Connor, or number 13, Batrell. Unassisted goal as he fires right back on Becori. Becori got most of that, but couldn't knock it down, Bronco.
Yep, Brendan had a good attempt there, but boy, that puck just kind of dribbled slowly into the net.
Center ice, man. I think cameraman a little confused on who scored, picking up Danny McCrail with the celebration. But that goal will go unassisted to Austin Batrell with 3:14 left to go here in the second period of play.
More shots of the fans here this afternoon. Watch the competition. Beautiful young ladies in the crowd here today. A lot of people coming in early this afternoon to get choice seats and get a slice of that championship pizza.
That goal not officially a power play goal as it came 2 seconds after the Farmington Hills Fire power play ended. And we get another whistle here right after the faceoff, and looks like somebody's being escorted to the penalty box once again.
Yep, here we go.
It's going to be number 11 to the sin bin. That's Nick Blankenberg, and boy, he's been valuable out there, Bronco.
Oh, he
not
sure
somebody
has.
That the coach wants in the penalty box.
Oh, you do not want him sitting down at all in competition.
And he's going to get the tripping call as he got the stick under the shins there of Danny McGrail. Took him down just as he was trying to work out of the faceoff circle with the biscuit. So he'll head off for 2 minutes or less. And not what the Cranks Hockey Club wants to do, as they put the Farmington Hills Fire right back on the power play. They have the 4-0 lead here, as Cranks so far has not been able to solve the stopper. We're back to action once again. And both of these goaltenders, very athletic out there. Small goaltenders, I guess you have to be, Bronco.
Yep, these guys are quick in the net, unlike me at 400 pounds, baby. I couldn't move in that net. I challenge you to get the puck past my crease.
That's right. Bronco used to fill up that whole net between the pipes, and that's why for a while he was neck and neck with Sawchuk for the shutout lead until the other team figured out how to score on it.
Yeah, well, instead of throwing octopi on the ice, they threw pizza, and I'd run out of the net and go grab a slice. It was a little cold, but what can you do? Still tasted good.
And they score in behind him. Shot deflected, comes in wide of Applebaum. Swept to the side of the net. Is getting in there is number 99, Boozer. And we'll work off to the far corner, jumping on the play. Number 21 over there, Garrett Hall. Tried to set up the point. He'll be chased back to the Cranks end. Cranks looking for the short-handed opportunity here. Been pinning the Fire back. Here come the Fire down, however, in the face-off circle, sweeping the shot right on as Boca picking it off with the big trapper there. It was Boncorry. He's working all the way down with it, Nick Boca. Take a look at some action once again from down low as Farmington Hills Fire on another power play here. Put the shot right in there on Boncorry. Stops that on the short side. That shot coming from the stick of Nick Boca. Face-off will stay to the left side of Boncorry as they square off. Push to the far boards. Big banging over there on the far side as Pokey got knocked off the puck, and we may have another penalty coming out of that.
Who, me? That's what he's saying right now. I didn't do it.
Is Merlini getting blamed for throwing a check right there, Bronco?
That's what it looks like. He's coming off.
This will put the Fire up on a 5-on-3 now. We'll take another look. Face off right here to the left side of Boncorry, and as it goes off into the corner, two players. Well, they were both going after the puck, Bronco, and I think that that arm should have stayed down on that play.
Yeah, that's a bit marginal.
That wasn't exactly a check. It was more two players going after the puck. And, well, they're calling an elbowing call on it, so maybe he got the elbow into him. A little tough to T-play. But 45 seconds, if I read that clock right. Well, a 5-on-3 opportunity now here for the Fire late in the second period of play, and they could really put this one out of reach on the Cranks Hockey Club, Bronco.
Yep, we got to stop this play right here. You don't want to get another goal in that right now with just a few ticks of the clock left in period two.
Cranks win the faceoff and will find an opening to send it back down into the Farmington Hills end. Kill some of that power play time. And Cranks down there on it first was number 19, Jones. Let the Fire take it away and look to work it out. Left wing side carrying all the way down is 00. Sensky stripped just as he looked to work into the zone. Back down and chasing after it goes Becker. Becker sweeps it around to the far side as that pops loose. Cranks trying to hold it in, but the Fire will push it back down to the Cranks blue line and now push it deep into the zone as they have to chase back across the end line there for it. Backhander put right on the stick for Barson with the shot. Oh, and a big stop for Boncorry once again, Bronco.
Yeah, Brendan Alert again.
That was, they tried to sweep it out on the backhand.
They're coming right at him again. A shot off and the post.
That looked like just got a piece of it was Boncorry as the fire with the heavy pressure.
Another shot.
Backhand shot on, and Boncorry will get it covered up. He takes a little bit of exception as coming crashing in on the play was, it looked like Marson once again. We'll take a look here down low. Is trying to sweep it out of there, Vanderveen, and it went right to Marson. He ripped it on the short side, but Boncorry was there, Bronco.
Sure was. Nice heads-up play.
And, you know, Farmington Hills Fire with the 5-on-3 advantage. Get a couple of good scoring opportunities here quickly as Eric Marson, quarterback in the power play out there for the Farmington Hills Fire. A couple of chances set up nicely. This one comes all the way back to the blue line. I believe stepping into this shot was Sensky. And you see Boncorry having to be solid. He's making snow angels out there now, Bronco.
Yep, they're firing darts at him.
Works loose in the slot once again. It's going to be a backhand shot here by number 8. That was Alger, A.A. And getting it covered in the blue ice. Was Boncorry took a little bit of exception to the extracurricular. Well, they've killed the two-man advantage. Now a one-man advantage for the Farmington Hills Fire with 39.4 left on the clock here in the second period of play. Some big stops in there for Boncorry. Faceoff will come to his left side. Marson wins it to the far side. Swept back here by Alger. Long shot knocked down in the faceoff circle. And Cranks will kick it loose back out through center ice. As they bang on each other along the near side, a couple of players going sliding down there, and looks like somebody else is being sent to the sin bin. Well, after no penalties in the first period of play, I believe this is the second trip for Billy Bob. And he's going to get caught for interference, it looks like. As Cranks trying to quickly move it ahead, looking for a shorthanded opportunity. And there you see a little bit of tangle up right there, and I believe that's your interference call. Is players collide with each other along the near boards, Bronco?
Yep, pile up right there. You can see three or four players right along the boards.
Well, the good news for Bronco is the youngsters are playing those games that we've got set up in the penalty box, Bronco.
That's right. They're playing that pizza pong, and all those proceeds are for a great cause, fans. That's to feed me right after this is over with today.
Pizza pong, cake mania, and we're already up to $11.50.
Boy,
we have another period like this. Bronco should be fairly well taken care of. As we're trying to actually save up for the PlayStation 3, but Bronco keeps eating all the profits, so what are you going to do?
Yep, we've got to take care of my physique.
Is that what it is? I figure it must be something like that. Late in the period, ooh, here we got some 4-on-4 hockey. And, oh, another little elbow thrown there, looked like, Bronco, but the whistle will stay quiet. The blue light and the horn, however, will come on. As we've completed two frames here at the Joe Louis Arena. As Matt Werner and company going to talk about it once again. As after completing 24 minutes of Squirt A Championship hockey, it's a 4-0 lead for the Farmington Hills Fire. And we've started to wear a path into the penalty boxes here. Here's Bronco to update you on the game stats.
Okay, after two periods of play, fans, let's see where we're at. Well, face shots on goal, the Fire with 20, the Cranks with 10. Face-offs won. Well, the Fire have the edge with 15, the Cranks with 8. Quality scoring chances, Farmington Hills 8, the Cranks Hockey Club 3. And look at your power plays here, 0 for 4 for the Fire, 0 for 3 for the Cranks. So we did have a rash of penalties here in the second period of play, and it's going to get pretty intense here as we get in the third period to decide this key matchup.
Well, both of these teams battling hard out there, and you should be battling to hunt us down here at the Joe Louis Arena so we can send you to Camp Wishy-Washy Wawa. There's your visual clue once again. A very famous hockey photo. We've not doctored in any way except to block part of it off. It was taken at the very end of a Stanley Cup series where the man in question scored the winning goal. If you use his last name, you should be able to make about any kind of medal. You got to think about that one a little bit. But if you can find us with the correct answer, boy, will you have a great prize. So hunt us down here at the JLA.
Well, some of the fans from Farmington Hills and Cranks Hockey Club have come up with a fantastic suggestion. They would like to have a Speedo tug of war after the contest.
Okay,
yeah, how about that?
What's the fantastic suggestion?
Well, they could get to pull on my Speedos. They're lucky people, aren't they, to be able to do that? If you were shown on the fan camera, if we caught you in the stands, you're the lucky winner, and you have to report to Center Ice after
Any
the game. That's right.
Real simple, man, I don't know if he's reporting. He's a little early. You don't have to report yet. Let's listen
like
in.
I did last time they played for this thing, but you know what? I'm going to show my appearance right here and give them the high fives and show them they're going to get their champion hat from Cranks.
Well, I think that man is undaunted making a Cranks victory prediction, Branko.
That's what it looks like here today. He's pretty pumped up for this, and we'd love to see that this afternoon.
It was either that or he was really excited about getting in on that Speedo tug-of-war.
That might be what it is.
Well, now he has to.
Well, yeah, he's pretty excited now.
Well, both goaltenders are ready. We're set to go start the third period. We start 4-on-4, and unless something else should happen, Cranks should get the upper hand with the power play here. And they could usually certainly use a power play goal to get this offense on track, Branko.
Yeah, that would sure do it. That'd be something we need to see here.
Long shot comes in, going to be stopped by Boncori. The official wanted him to play it, but he bear hugs it at the post there. A man in the striped shirt giving him a lecture about it, it looks like, Branko.
Yep, here's some of the Cranks fan club. They've
got Crankettes!
Yes, they've got the jersey working here today. Nice sweatshirts.
Got the double ponytails going, looking cute out there, supporting their favorite hockey club and players. This is worked around behind the cage by Venuto. Goes around to the far side, jumping into the action comes Petrell, but here comes Cranks down the ice, right wing side. Carrying all the way in, looks like Jonesy. Jonesy comes out front. Oh, and he couldn't get the good shot away. He got tied up, and Applebaum able to get the big goalie pedal out front. Backhand shot at the side of the net.
Coming
out
at again.
And good defensive work by the Fire.
Big oh,
44, Robbie Flannery just took out a Fire. He put that Fire out, Branko.
Boy, he hit him, didn't he? Robbie Flannery can't wait until he plays Pee-wee so he can check legally. An all-A student at Our Lady Queen of Martyrs in Beverly Hills. He was an all-star in his baseball league last summer.
Well, I don't know if we'd exactly call that one a check, but he certainly ran over one of the Fire players. Play goes in along the far boards. In there is number 88, Ryan Werner. And I think instead of Flannery, it's going to be double that number for Flannery. It's going to be 88. Ryan Werner, who's getting escorted to the sin bin. And then we got a little press kit information on Werner as he takes a seat.
Well, Ryan Werner, Ryan's dad, is actually the head coach. His cousin played at U of M and currently plays in the American Hockey League.
We'll see the play along the boards here. And Werner gets in the middle of it. Haven't seen anything that might be a penalty yet, but, they called it somewhere in there. And we'll go back a little earlier to take a look at this chance for Cranks Hockey Club. As I believe this is number 19, Jonesy works all the way in, gets in behind the fence, using that reach nicely, Branko, but then the puck drifted away from him. He didn't get a really good shot in there on Applebaum. Stayed with the play nicely, got it back out into the slot. And Cranks got to go back after a backhand there. I believe that was Venuto got that off, just missed it wide. As he nearly slid that inside the post, Branko.
Yep, he sure did. They're still coming at him. A lot of activity down at this end of the ice.
Trying to get the pass back out front again was Max Jones, but a couple of Fire players denied him the pass. And 10:45 here left to go in our third period of play as 88's got to go to the sin bin. We're back to some 4-on-4 skating. We've had plenty of room out there for most of this contest, Branko.
Yeah, it's interesting that we went through that first period and with no penalties, now all of a sudden a rash of them in two periods.
Yeah, it's like officials just changed their mind on what they wanted to do with the penalty calls here today. Boca chases back down into his own end to pick up the biscuit as the Farmington Hills Fire will begin work on a power play. Quickly sent ahead to the left wing side, too far, however. And Cranks will heave it back in deep into the Fire end once again. carried around behind Applebaum. Pass sent over on the right wing side. Long sweeping pass sent ahead. Oh! Left wing side. Pierce trying to get it back there as it got knocked off of his stick. He'll chase it down along the boards. Big Jacob Pierce out there. And Jacob takes his number from Owen Nolan, although he likes Joe Thornton of San Jose. And he's happy with bread and water to eat. No, actually, that bread would be pizza bread as he works on it in the corner there. Big Jacob. And he wants to go of U of M. He goes to college. And he's great at picking up the garbage in front of the other team's net and scoring. Wears a zip-up Batman-looking suit under his equipment. Well, me and my girlfriend used to dress as Batman and Robin all the time, but we won't really get into that discussion. This is picked off the boards, turned around by Levering. And, of course, Bronco, after his years in the NHL, was the stunt double for Barney the Dinosaur.
Yeah, I sure was. And, yeah, I had him outsized a little bit, though. I had to lose a little weight, get me down to that trim 400 to do that.
Well, Bronco wasn't able to do the dances that Barney usually does either.
Yeah, I went to a Halloween party once in a whole big white sheet. I went as the whole state of Alaska.
That shot comes right in. Look out. Another crashing in on the net. There is Boncori getting it covered, and he's been upset a little bit by these Farmington Hills Fire players in this period, Bronco.
Yep, more a shot of the fans here today, whispering, young lady whispering.
That's the Crankettes up there once again. Face off to the right side. We'll take a look at some of the action from down low. This is swept back to the blue line by Dylan Jones, Dill Pickles. Long shot taken and getting the deflection right there. Nice job with the right leg save. As Marson got the deflection, then jumped in there, tried to stuff it through. Taking him out on the play was Venuto. And did we get a penalty on this play? Marson getting up off the ice. Dylan Jones right there as well, looking for some trash to pick up. And I got to like Dill Pickles out there. Not only does his hockey, does his nickname make me hungry, but he wears his number because of Stevie Eiserman. His favorite hockey players are Eiserman and somebody else I can't mention because that might give away our Hall of Famer. As, basically, one of his favorite hockey players is our Hall of Famer. Losing the stick there is Bon Corey. Yeah, as the play whistled down again.
They're getting a little testy out there now.
Well, number 19, Dill Pickles. If he gets hit, he will always go after the person and hit them back. Will always sign his autograph. Dill Pickles, Bronco.
Well, I'm going to get me an autograph right after the contest.
I'm going to get me a hamburger.
Yep, sounds good with some pickles, relish, mustard. Woo-hoo!
Dill Pickles on it. That's tapped back to the blue line by Dill Pickles. Shot swept in there by Senske, but it's deflected wide. Pushed back in around behind the cage by Alger. Goes off to the far corner. This looks like Dill Pickles right there. Pushes it back for Senske again. Fires the shot right on, and Bon Corey was there through some traffic, Bronco.
Yep, another great save by Brendan.
Is Farmington Hills working this power play pretty well, moving the puck around, but it'll be Cranks to steal it away. Nice diving stop by Becker to hold it in the zone. But Cranks jumped right back on it, send a pass to the right wing side. But we got a whistle stopping the action here, Bronco.
Yeah, a lot of stoppages in this period early. It looks like we're going to have a penalty. He's pleading his case, but not me, Ref.
Well, it's number 88 heading right back to the box. Werner, he's only been about 30 seconds out of the box. He must have, I think he was playing Cake Mania, Bronco.
Yeah, he wanted to finish that game.
Well, the only problem is, according to our computer sensor, he's feeding washers into our
washers
machine.
Is that what he's been doing?
Thank
I'm going to talk to his teacher tomorrow.
That's cheating. There you see the hooking call right there as he got it caught under the arm there of Eric Marson. Marson may have helped that call a little bit by holding on to the stick, Bronco.
Well, that's called the acting you use when it comes to hockey.
Oh, well, we got a second player being escorted out. This may be a bench minor. We're not sure of the call on this one. But joining him in the penalty box is going to be number 14. Well, that's Joey Vassilo. He's put in the penalty box. He's got a broken wrist. I don't think he's playing, Bronco.
I don't think he is either here this afternoon, but he's going to the penalty box.
I think Matt Werner is just making sure that everybody that is playing is available, because if that was a bench minor, he just might have gotten away with it one by putting... Well, he's dressed, but he's not playing. He can sit in the penalty box, I guess, Bronco.
Yep, I guess that's what's going to happen here. Unusual play. Well, Joey Fasello's Crank's winger. He started his hockey career at age 7 in Royal Oak Lindell Arena. His hometown is Troy, Michigan, where he attends Bemis Elementary School, and he's in the 4th grade.
Look
good
out.
Socky.
Steal away here by Theo Harris. Backhand shot, and he scores.
Oh, they're getting cranky now.
Oh, against a 5-on-3. He stole it away as going down was Grzycki, and picking it up right there was Tommy Theo Harris. Works it all the way in and makes a couple of beautiful moves getting in here on Applebaum. A shorthanded goal, down two players, flicks the backhand over the left shoulder of Applebaum, and the stopper couldn't catch up with that one. Perfect backhand shot off the stick of number 12, Tommy Theo Harris, at the big-time shorthanded goal for the Cranks Hockey Club, Bronco.
Oh, that goal was huge. Oh, so huge.
Oh, that'll draw them a bit closer, and boy, this is just what the Cranks Hockey Club might need to get the fire lit under them to beat the fire, Bronco.
Yep, they might get really on a roll now.
You see, as Grzycki has a hard time handling it. And then
nice
move to get around Boca. Now he's coming in on Applebaum just like a penalty shot. Boca tries to get that stick in front of the shot, but that crawls right up the body there of Applebaum and beats him over the left shoulder into the top of the net, Bronco.
Yep. Now it's interesting, getting real interesting, fans.
Jumping for joy is Tommy Theo Harris. And he's got a nifty celebration going on after breaking the goose egg and getting Cranks Hockey Club on the board. Shorthanded by two players, Bronco.
That's incredible. You sure do not see that very often at all.
Well, face off. Well, they still got to kill this power play, however, by the Farmington Hills Fire, who can add to their lead with the player advantage coming across as Boca sends the pass over to the faceoff circle for Juszczyk. He's got to track it down along the boards in behind the net for McGrail. Look out for McGrail, who's been a playmaker. Puck is loose. Goaltender's down. Oh, look out. Don't want to cover
that
puck. And finally, it ends up underneath Bon Corey, as it looked like Garrett Hall was trying to cover the puck outside the crease there, and that would have been a penalty shot, Bronco.
Yeah, it would have, and Bon Corey does not want to give up a goal here.
Penalty shot or a penalty, as there you see, unable to get control of it was Bon Corey. Right there in the middle of it is McGrail, and he's figured into a couple of these fire goals, I believe. They continue to scramble. You scramble, and you see 21 Garrett Hall trying to get it covered. Finally, it squirts loose back in on Bon Corey, and he is the one that turtles over the top of it. Solid save. Brendan Bon Corey has been doing a great job in between those pipes for Cranks, Bronco.
Well, he sure has, because they've been just firing at him all afternoon, and he's very agile, a great athlete.
Fire will take control of it, swing it over for Becker. Becker with the long shot that whistles in wide, may have deflected off of somebody out front. As Cranks trying to clear it out of the zone, steer it up the near side. Pat thrown ahead by Connor Jean. Working down with it, here comes Inger. Inger gets tangled up with number 15, Anastas, and looks like we got another tripping call coming here, Bronco.
That's what it looks like. Yeah, he's headed, ref's explaining it to him here, and he's sending him in.
Well, Superman, alias Drew Anastas, gets to play Pizza Pong or Cake Mania for a couple minutes or less. We'll see if we can pick up the call here. I think that would be it. Bronco, he just whipped the stick at the shins of Max Jones, and Jonesy goes down, and the official right there. That one's not going to get past anyone, Bronco.
No, it sure isn't. Even the goaltender's pointing it out.
Well, that would be his own teammate. I don't know why he would do. Maybe he's pointing at somebody else.
He is. He's pointing something. I don't think he agrees.
Well, still going to be a power play right now for the Fire, as Crank still serving that double minor. 4-on-3 power play now, however, for Farmington Hills Fire. Unless we get another penalty called, it'll be Crank stand up with a chance on the power play. Look out, coming all the way down with it. Oh, number 19 was coming down. Great back job of back checking there by Connor Jean, as Dill Pickles was coming in on a penalty shot on Bon Corey, Bronco.
Well, he sure was there. Heads up play.
Oh, it's Dill Pickles getting his legs chopped out a little bit, it looked like by the other number 19, Jones. There's a shot right on. And gobble. Oh, hacking going on there from the goaltender. And I think we're going to get a penalty called against Boncori, Bronco.
It looks like he's pointing to him right now.
Well, somebody's going to have to serve a penalty for the goaltender, and this is not what Cranks wants right here, Bronco.
No, they don't want any more penalties now. They're just getting back into this.
They're trying to get the momentum here in this contest. As I believe that was number 13, Connor Jean, coming in to serve the penalty. As we'll take a look, Bill Pickles being leaned on. Right there by the other number 19, Max Jones, along with Dylan Jones. So the two Jones boys meeting up on the ice. Both Jones, but on different teams. There you see the backhander coming in. And I don't know if Boncori's got that in the glove or between the legs, but it takes a chop at, I believe that's Marson in there looking for the garbage to put in behind the net. Marson goes down, and one of the officials decides that to call the penalty against the goaltender, Bronco.
Yep, you don't see it too often. We see it here this afternoon.
So it'll remain a power play chance for the Farmington Hills Fire as they're explaining it over at the bench here. Looks like to the head coach of the Cranks Hockey Club. Well, what do we got? Thought somebody else was good. Well, somebody else is going to be led to the penalty box, Bronco.
Yep, they're moving somebody in right now here.
I don't know. I'll have to tally this up here now. I don't know where we're at. Chris Andrus being escorted to the box, and we may have one too many in the box to fit up on the board now, Bronco.
Yep, it looks like it. Not many players on the ice.
Well, it's still 4-on-3 in favor of the Farmington Hills Fire. There's a shot deflected. Comes right in on Boncori. But he gets a piece of it to steer it aside. Fire will collect it once again, send it back to the blue line for Grosicki. Grosicki takes a second swipe at it, passes it over for number 8, Alger, who flings it into the corner. Marson doing battle in there with Cranks. Is dug out of there, jumping in there was number 11, Blankenberg. Blankenberg put in a solid game for his team. A nice job by the Fat Force to move up on it. Gets to Marson. Marson can't get the shot off, and the stick's getting up there a little bit between these teams, Bronco.
That's getting rough out there.
It's beginning to get the idea that these two teams don't like each other out there.
Yeah, they can't wait till they get in that checking division, I'm sure.
Knocked glove down by Marson. Sends it into the slot, and a good job getting over there to block things up by Inger. Pass sent ahead, too far out of the reach, but Fire have to chase back into their own end for it. That's Boca, and we get another whistle, and it looks like another penalty. This is going to be number 8, Austin Alger, who's got to go to the sin bin. We'll look at this play, see if we can pick it up. And number 8 getting caught for hooking, according to the official. See Marson jumping, knocking down the pass. But Vic Blankenberg, I bet you he can't. There's the hook right there, I believe. Could have been a slash, but he got the stick up into the body of Inger. Inger eventually going down on the play. Drew the penalty call, Bronco.
Yep, a lot of penalties. Many, many penalties so far.
See number 11 out there, Nick Blankenberg. Boy, is he a hard worker for this Cranks team. Take one more look at chance here on the power play for Farmington Hills Fire as they pass it back for Boca. Boca sends the shot. It's deflected off of Marson. Came right in on Boncori, and Boncori, boy, he's had to be super alert in this championship contest, Bronco.
He's getting a workout, that's for sure. Great player.
A little late getting the penalty up on the board. It's number 13 serving the second penalty, which must have been a bench minor. Connor Jean serving the second penalty against the Cranks Hockey Club. So right now we've got 3-on-3 skating, Bronco.
A lot of room on the ice right now.
And should the whistle slow down, it'll end up a power play for Cranks Hockey Club. But right now some 3-on-3 skating going on. Working all the way down with it is McGrail, but it's finally stolen away from him. Good job of back checking by Cranks. Coming back on the play, I believe that was Levering. And it's sent back out to neutral ice. It's sent between the two penalty boxes. Another player lands on the ice. Levering chases it down. And a long pass ahead up to the Farmington Hills blue line. Jumping all over it is Jones. Took it away from Becker. It'll be kicked back down into the Cranks end. This looks like Levering chasing it down. He'll flip it on the backhand around the near corner. Cranks getting over there. Trying to work it out. 44. Flannery trying to spin away from his man. And it will be worked out for Cranks. Picked up by Jones. Here's Jonesy. Jonesy has it knocked off his stick, goes after it in the corner, looks out front, being watched closely by Sense. Look out, it pops out loose out front and swept at, but a swing and a miss. And McGrail will steer it back down the ice. Look out, all the way down comes Sense, shot right on, and Bon Corey comes up with a huge save for the Krantz Hockey Club, Bronco.
Well, he gives it all up, doesn't he?
Lost his glove and his stick there on the play as that came in. And, well, we've got a trail being beat to the sin bin now, Bronco.
Yep, this is absolutely incredible.
Number 14, Juszczyk being put in the penalty box. I believe he's getting caught for a slashing call. We'll see if we can find it here on the replay. As you see the long pass sent ahead, and I believe that's the double out spy, Sensi, getting the shot off. But coming up onto the white ice to pick up the challenge there was Bon Corey. There you see the player coming late, Juszczyk, and, well, he may have got there after the whistle. I really didn't see a slash in there, Bronco.
That's what it looks like. That's the only play I can think of.
Unless he slashed the Cranks player just as they skated off camera view there. But another fire player put in the box. It's a full house in the sin bin now, Bronco.
Yeah, look at this. Look at that board lit up now.
So the Cranks Hockey Club could come out of this in good shape as long as they don't get somebody sent to the penalty box. And according to our tote board, Bronco, we're up to $35 now.
Oh, that's great.
I might even get something to eat.
Yeah, you're getting one breadstick.
Fat Force trying to get the pass out front. Number 13 fighting for it there is Betrell as Crank surrounds him and takes away the biscuit. Send it back out. Looks like Crank's back up to a full complement of players out there, Bronco. Yep. That's been a rarity for the last two periods.
It sure has been.
Is trying to work it out the fire. They'll push it back out through center ice. Crank stop it just inside their own zone. And we'll start it up again. There's a long shot taken. That skips in. And they score!
Oh, Cranky baby!
Number 24! An unassisted goal. Marino Merlini just let it fly. Got a deflection, I think, from a Farmington Hills Fire defenseman. But he stopped it off the boards. And I think his team may have been changing. Took a look and said, I'll take this myself. Steps one step inside the blue line, let it fly. I think he got a deflection off of Boca. It crossed up Applebaum as he was moving to his right along the post and went back the other direction, got past the stopper, and that'll be a power play goal for Cranks Hockey Club to get back within a couple swings of the hockey stick. Here you see it, letting it fly, and it ticked off the glove there of Boca. That crossed up Applebaum behind him as he made a commitment far to his right side. And I think he was expecting the shot to go wide. Huge goal for Cranks Hockey Club from Marino Merlini.
That's a great name, isn't
it? That's right. He's going to get all kinds of endorsements when he gets to the NHL.
He sure will. With a name like that, I can just see the little cards in that he's going to be giving out.
Oh, M&M closes it down to within two goals for Cranks Hockey Club on a power play goal. I think they're still working on the power play out there as they got a chance to close within one, Bronco.
They sure do. We've got a brand new contest right now, folks.
Is the time working against Cranks Hockey Club, but still plenty of time left in this hockey club game for them to draw within one and see if they can get it to a tie score and possible overtime, Bronco.
I'm sure that's what the coach has on his mind right now.
Yet another whistle stops the action, and what we got here? It may be just an offsides this time.
They're on their feet right now. We've got a barn burner here, a cliffhanger, call it what you will.
Starting to bite their nails up here in these seats, Bronco.
They sure are. Go, go. They're yelling it now.
And this faceoff's going to come all the way back down deep into the Farmington Hills end. In to take it is Jones. And it's Jones against Anastas. And Farmington Hills Fire sweep it around the corner. Off to the boards, tracking it down as Cranks Hockey Club push it back behind the Fire cage. Off along the boards, jumping in there as Boozer. Rebound Ronnie, hoping that he gets a chance to put one into the back of the cage. Look out! Here come the Farmington Hills Fire, but good job of back checking. Get it right back. Shot on the short side and a big stop for Bon Corey. And boy, they needed that stop, Bronco.
All the saves that Brendan make right now are stellar.
And they are huge, oh so huge at this point. As you see a nice little pass coming from Jacob Pierce, and the Farmington Hills Fire get it cranked up coming down the ice. Trying to pick up the number there. I'm not sure if that's Becker. And it looked like number 24, Merlini, stopped that, but it come right squirted loose. And a shot on the short side. Having a hard time picking up that number. That may have been Austin Alger, the AA, trying to give Farmington Hills Fire a little extra insurance, Bronco.
Yep, we're down to just a few minutes left here, and it's getting pretty exciting and testy.
It'll be face-off controlled by Farmington Hills. Stopped in the slot just below the hash marks, and Cranks will pick it up. Fire is centering pass, a little bit behind number 19. Had to spin back for it. Jones can't pick it up, and here comes Marson across for Farmington Hills Fire. Alger gets a stick on it. This will be chased down by the man with the Gretzky number on, Boozer. And hits the skate there of the Fat Force, but look out! In behind
it's
the plate, coming
shot
down with it is Merlini. Merlini
it over.
Sends the pass. Merlini gets it back. They jam away at it and get it covered. It'll be Applebaum as a little extracurricular at the side of the net. And there looks like they're going to give Marson a trip to the sin bin, Bronco.
Yep, referee Hancock is leading him over.
Boy, man, this game, boy, we could make a lot of extra money on our hockey games by covering these guys every game, Bronco.
Yep, it's been a long time since we've seen this many penalties in a contest.
Bronco's going for steak with all the trimmings after this contest.
And valet parking, even.
In behind the play, this was Garrett Hall, not Merlini, I'm sorry. He sends the pass across. Nice little touch pass right back to Hall, but Hall couldn't get anything on it to stuff it through on the short side, Bronco.
Yeah, he didn't have a lot of mustard on the puck.
You see, doing some extra stuffing was Max Jones, and finally getting tired of that was Eric Marson. He gets pointed out by the man with the striped shirt, going to get a roughing call with 2:04 left to go here in the third, and right now, Cranks Hockey Club would like to jam another one home, Bronco.
Well, that would be a big goal if they could put it in here.
Well, the faceoff will be deep in the Fire end, won by the Cranks Hockey Club. There's a shot toward the net, and getting a stick on it to deflect it wide with Sensky up the boards, but not out. It'll be held in as Cranks Hockey Club pull their goaltender for a 6-on-4 chance now, Bronco.
Yep, they're taking the chance. They're pulling the stops out.
That's swept into the slot, goes all the way through to the boards, however. As jumping in there comes Cranks Hockey Club. Comes loose. Look out. Oh, trying to sweep the shot on was Hall. And off along the near boards. Another whistle stops things. And it looks like
penalty.
We got a tripping call here. Who's this going to go against? It's going to go against the Fire once again, Bronco.
Yep, they did not want that right now either. And, wow, this is going to be a wild finish.
I think it's Bryce Becker, Billy Bob, that they caught for tripping. These players must really like those games, Bronco.
Yep, they must be going back in there. We might have a PlayStation 3 before long.
Let's see if we can pick up. Well, there's the swing cutting number 21 down at the shins there, Garrett Hall. Is swinging the stick right at his legs was Bryce Becker. Billy Bob's got to go to the sin bin, and tough to get away with ones like that, Bronco.
Oh, yeah, you got to be a little bit more crafty than that.
So, 5-on-3 chance now for the Cranks Hockey Club. Unless there's another penalty call, they'll be on a power play the rest of the game. Shot toward the net, big rebound, kicked away. They try and get the shot back on net off the stick of Levering. Trying his luck, Robbie Flannery took the long shot, but it's worked back out to center ice by the Fire. Cranks will get it back in front of their own blue line, working it down again. Nice little move here. Here comes number 19, Jones. There's Jonesy. Oh, and it tripped off his stick. Good defensive
it's
work.
It's out again.
And Estes by the shot. And
it's
good.
Oh, Cranks do it.
Oh, Tommy Theo Harris with the second goal of the period. Puts Crank Hockey Club within a goal, Bronco.
Oh, my goodness gracious, can you believe this?
And they're still be working on the power plays. Take a look, nice stick handling work down by Max Jones. He skates right through the Farmington Hills Fire defense, but a nice job of back checking before he can pull the trigger here, Bronco. But Cranks Hockey Club with a 5-on-3 out there. They get the pass back out front, and the goaltender is down, firing the shot. Tommy Theo Harris with Applebaum down on the ice. Big celebration, actually a 6-on-3 chances. Head coach Matt Werner pulling out all the stops, pulling the goaltender up on a 5-on-3 power play, Bronco.
Well, makes him look like a genius right now.
As you see, nice move to work it into the zone by
nice
Max
play
Jones.
There, nice skating.
Good job of back checking right here, levering Anastas spoiling the chance, getting back on the play, Bronco. But number 19, Jones, stayed with it, sent the pass back out front. It found Theo Harris, and he found the back of the net with Applebaum sitting on the goal line. What a hockey game this has turned into, Bronco.
Wow, this is really, doesn't get more exciting than this. Look at the cranks jumping in the air. They got it cranked up, baby.
Big dance of celebration. Second goal for Theo Harris to bring his hockey club back within one. It's still a power play opportunity out there for Cranks Hockey Club, Bronco.
Oh, this is great. 1:06 to go. Can they tie it up?
I'm sure they'll pull Bon Corey again right away. It's flipped out of the faceoff circle by the Fire. As here comes the Cranks Hockey Club bringing it across the blue line at the top of the slot looking for the shot. Nice job to block that off. Yes, that was worked in. Long shot taken wide of the cage by Gene. Goes to the far circle, tapped away from the dangerous Theo Harris. Let the Cranks get it back, send the shot toward the net. It's loose at the side of the net. Theo Harris getting the stick on it again. There's all the Cranks hockey clubs in there. Backhand shot. Tipped wide, trying to get a deflection.
Oh,
at the side of the net. Puck still loose as they jam away. And right in the middle of it there, Boca trying to work it out for Farmington Hills Fire, as the goaltender gone once again for Cranks, pulling out all the stops. Along the boards, Marsa trying to get it loose. It's held in.
Passes it out front.
Slot out. Oh, and Theo Harris couldn't knock down the pass to get the shot off. As number 13 getting the stick on it. Connor Jean along the far boards. Oh, tries to tap it back for Flannery. Comes loose to the zone. Flannery sends it in, but it'll be offsides, and that'll just about be it in this contest, Bronco.
Wow, slow up and catch your breath. Wow.
Take a look as Cranks Hockey Club, they're coming from all angles here. As they've got, I believe, 6-on-4 out there right now. See the shot coming in wide, tracking it down quickly. Garrett Hall backhands it back. Oh, and there was a huge chance. Didn't even see that through the crowd. His number 11, Blankenberg, nearly tied this hockey game, Bronco.
Yep, so close, you just saw it.
And right in there on the action, too, was Robbie Flannery. As we're back to it, I think they called that an intentional offside. Sent the faceoff all the way down. That's going to do it. Time runs out. That faceoff was with 2.2 seconds left. The Farmington Hills Fire hold on to win it 4-3 over Cranks Hockey Club. What a Squirt A championship here in the Iserman Division, Bronco.
That doesn't get any better than this at all, folks. It doesn't.
Our final through 36 minutes of championship hockey, the Farmington Hills Fire win it 4-3 over Cranks Hockey Club. And here's Bronco to bring you our final game stats.
All right, I'll take a deep breath now. Let's do our final game stats. Shots on goal, the Fire had 29, the Cranks 17. Faceoffs won. Fire with 23, Cranks with 18. Quality scoring chances. Fire with 10, Cranks with 8. And look at the penalties, folks. Power play percentages. The Fire 0 for 8. The Cranks 2 for 8. What an exciting matchup here. A treat to watch, definitely, fans.
And a shorthanded goal for Cranks as they really did crank it up in that third period. They needed about a couple more minutes on the clock. And nobody was able to find us here either for our Hall of Famer question. We may give out a free one to Fat Force anyway. Luke Krasicki would love the Camp Wishy-Washy Wawa. But there you see our visual clue once again. A very famous hockey photo taken at the very end of a Stanley Cup series where the man in question, who hails from Beantown, if you can recognize that half a logo, scored the winning goal to give his team the victory in this Stanley Cup series. If you used his last name, you could make just about any kind of medal. Well, that's because his last name is Orr. And you should know the rest of the name. He is often credited with changing the way defense was played in the NHL. It's Bobby Orr, as you see him flying through the air after giving his Boston Bruins the Stanley Cup victory, Branko.
That's right. He looks like he's auditioning for the next Superman movie. You can see the fans in the background on their feet. What a play. A classic hockey photo.
That's right. Some lucky photographer snapped that photo, and you can pretty much find that in any hockey history book. Of Bobby Orr scoring that winning goal, which I think was actually in overtime in Game 7 against the Blues, if you recognize the other logo there. What a great hockey player Bobby Orr, number 4, was, Branko.
He sure was. He's one of the best to ever skate up.
Well, the Farmington Hills Fire had to fight off a blazing Cranks hockey team in that third period to secure this victory, Branko, but secure it they did.
Wild and woolly affair, very exciting.
Yeah, we're ready to hand out some championship hardware down here on the ice. Yeah, looks like we're going to go a little against the norm here. We're handing out the MVP of the game first, and it's going to go to the Double Ought Spy, Tyler Senske, Branko.
Yep, it sure is. He carries his plaque away.
He picked up the first goal in this hockey game. He was great at both ends of the ice. Excellent defense out in front of his goaltender, the stopper Applebaum, all game long. And now we're handing out championship hardware to your Cranks Hockey Club. First up is Austin Levering. Austin putting in a tough game out there. Had some good chances. Number 10, Connor Enger. Boy, he's not afraid to play the physical game out there for his coach. And following him up, number 11, Nick Blankenberg, all over that ice. A real playmaker out there for this Cranks hockey team. Played a great game today. And Tommy Theo Harris put in 2 goals in that third period of play. He'd like to have gotten a third one, I'm sure, Branko. Connor Jean, who's got an excellent shot for this Cranks hockey team. And number 14, Joey Vassalo. He kind of got into the game on the penalty box there. You see his wrist in the cast there as he's got the broken wrist, unable to play today. Max Jones-Jonesy, a big leader for this team. He picked up an assist out there. 21, Garrett Hall, dangerous every second he's out there on the ice for this Cranks hockey club. Number 22, Chris Andrus. Another hard-working winger for this squad with good speed. Number 24, a big physical player, Marino Merlini, who's definitely got the name that rolls right off the tongue. He picked up the Cranks' second goal. Number 33, William Vanderveen, doing a lot of hard physical duty for his head coach. Robbie Flannery, he's just excellent back on that blue line, not afraid to jump into the offense as well. And 88, big Ryan Werner, as he's a tank out there for the Cranks hockey team. Number 91, Jack Venuto, another hard-working member of this defensive unit, and with great speed out there, Ron Boozer, rebound Ronnie. Then you've got Brendan Boncorry, and boy, did Brendan stand on his head in that third period, gave the Cranks hockey club every chance he could, Branko.
He sure did. I admire the youngster.
Looks like your captains and assistants, heck with it, the whole team going to come up and get this sponsor's trophy. Your coaching staff once again for Cranks Hockey Club. Head coach is Matt Werner. Brad Jones, one of your assistant coaches, who is actually an NHL player. Andrew Boncorry, Rob Flannery out there, and your manager is Rick Merlini. Unfortunately, we weren't able to work in all this information that we've got on the Cranks Hockey Club's coaches. But if you want to know more, just go see Matt Werner at one of the Werner Hallmark card shops that he owns around town. And now we're going to get the fans giving a round of applause to their Farmington Hills Fire, your Squirt A Iserman champions. Once again, we see Tyler Senske. Solid game for him out there. Your MVP picking up the first goal in today's contest, Nick Boca, who is a big physical player out there, worked hard in this one, as did Eric Marson. Boy, he loves to crash the net. He was all over Boncorry a few times. Great job on the both ends of the ice for Bryce Becker. Billy Bob spent a little time in the penalty box, but had a great game, picking up a goal out there. Austin Alger, double A out there. And then you've got number 10, Danny McGrail, who's a definite playmaker out there. He picked up a goal and an assist. Big Jacob Pierce, who's a physical player in these corners for these team. Austin Petrell got speed and a great scoring touch. He ends up with the game-winning goal for the Farmington Hills Fire. Colin Juszczyk, the Spider-Man, when he's not playing climbing the walls, he's playing great hockey. And you've got Drew Anasta, Superman, out there. And number 77 up next, Luke Grasicki of the Fat Force. That's taken from Luke Skywalker, the Force, but I'm still not sure of the Fat. Dylan Jones, Dill Pickle, my favorite nickname. Then you've got Kyle McCullough, Pokey. And finally, Spencer Applebaum, number one because he is number one, the stopper who stopped enough for those Cranks Hockey Club shots to help bring this one home for the Farmington Hills Fire. They'll all skate up to get that sponsor's trophy. Your coaching staff, once again, head coach is Joe Jones, helped out by Gary Becker, Kelvin Alger, Mike McCullough, and Tom Anastas. Your managers, Terry Grasicki and Susan Buttrell.
Yep, look at there. Grab that championship trophy there. Hold it high. They're pretty excited. The fans are on their feet.
Well, it's time for us to wrap it up. What a game here at the Joe Louis Arena today. The Farmington Hills Fire hang on 4-3 over Cranks Hockey Club to take the Little Caesars Squirt A Iserman Championship. But remember, ladies and gentlemen, it's not whether you win or lose here on Play-By-Play. It's how you play the game. For Play-By-Play, I have been Rance Ford.
This is Bronco Bobby Wawa. It's time to get to center ice for a tug-of-war in my Speedos. Come on down, fans. You're going to love it.
I forgot about that. I'm going to spend your money for the penalty box.
Hit me with your best shot.